tells us that God originally created hell for the devil and his angels. Hell is described as a place of unimaginable torment. The cries of those in hell and the smoke of their torment never stop. Hell is the eternal punishment for all those who have broken God's law, the Ten Commandments, and rebelled against God. Hell is described as the lake of fire, the bottomless pit, everlasting fire, outer darkness, and the second death. Jesus refers to hell many times in the Bible. He said, "Ye serpents, ye generation of vipers, how can you escape the damnation of hell?" Mark 9:47-48. "And if thine eye offend thee, pluck it out. It is better for thee to enter into the kingdom of God with one eye than having two eyes to be cast into hell fire, where their worm dieth not, and the fire is not quenched." Luke 12:5. "But I will forewarn you whom ye shall fear. Fear him which after he hath killed hath power to cast into hell. Yea, I say unto you, fear him." And in Revelation, the Bible gives us a clearer description of those who will go to this place forever. "But the fearful and unbelieving and abominable and murderers and whoremongers and sorcerers and idolaters and all liars shall have their part in the lake which burneth with fire and brimstone, which is the second death." Be honest with yourself. We have all been guilty of one of these sins at some point in our lives. And time or turning over a new leaf is not going to take that fact away. We are all on our way to a lost eternity in hell on account of our sins.
"Now the works of the flesh are evident, which are adultery, fornication, uncleanness, lewdness, idolatry, sorcery, hatred, contentions, jealousies, outbursts of wrath, selfish ambitions, dissensions, heresies, envy, murders, drunkenness, revelries, and the like, which I tell you beforehand, just as I also told you in time past, that those who practice such things will not inherit the kingdom of God."
What is heaven like? The Bible tells us that heaven was created by God and is God's home, a place of unimaginable joy, splendor, and peace. The Bible tells us that God is holy and will not allow sin in his presence. Heaven is a holy place where God is worshipped as the great King and Creator of the universe. The Bible speaks about heaven in the book of Revelation and tells us about the crystal sea, golden streets, angels, seraphims, amazing beauty, and God's throne room.
"After these things I looked, and behold, a door standing open in heaven. And the first voice which I heard was like a trumpet speaking with me.
Come up here, and I will show you things which must take place after this.
Immediately I was in the Spirit, and behold, a throne set in heaven, and one sat on the throne. And he who sat there was like a jasper and a sardius stone in appearance. And there was a rainbow around the throne, in appearance like an emerald. Around the throne were 24 thrones, and on the thrones I saw 24 elders sitting, clothed in white robes, and they had crowns of gold on their heads." "And from the throne proceeded lightning, thundering, and voices. 7 lamps of fire were burning before the throne, which are the 7 spirits of God. Before the throne there was a sea of glass like crystal, and in the midst of the throne and around the throne, creatures full of eyes in front and in back. The first living creature was like a lion, The second living creature, like a calf. The third living creature had a face like a man. And the fourth living creature was like a flying eagle. The four living creatures, each having six wings, were full of eyes around them, and they do not rest day or night.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come.
Whenever the living creatures give glory and honor and thanks to him who sits on the throne, who lives forever and ever, the 24 elders fall down before him who sits on the throne and worship him who lives forever and ever, and cast their crowns before the throne.
You are worthy, O Lord, to receive glory and honor and power, for you created all things, and by your will they exist and were created.
A common misconception about heaven is that we will be doing nothing for eternity. However, the Bible tells us that our bodies will be changed and we will serve God forever. Our lives in heaven will be 1,000 times more fulfilling and interesting than they are here on the earth. Heaven is also a place where there is no war, no more pain, no evil or sin, and God himself will wipe away every tear from our eyes. The Bible tells us that only the righteous will be in heaven, and the wicked will not be allowed to enter. The question is, are you good enough to go to heaven? The fact is, none of us want to suffer in hell, and we all want to live in the beauty of heaven. But our problem is that we have broken God's law, and the punishment for this is hell. You may say you're not a bad person, but when compared to the Ten Commandments or God's moral standard, we all fall short. Even our God-given conscience tells us we have done wrong before God. As we have said before, God is holy and will not tolerate sin or rebellion in his presence. And because he is a just judge, he must punish sin. Think about this. God is so completely holy that the only punishment befitting those who fall short of his eternal holiness is eternal torment in hell. A day of judgment is coming, when God shall hold us all to account for every sin we have ever committed. But there is hope. God is not only holy, he is also very loving and merciful, and is not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. The price for sin is physical and spiritual death. God, in his amazing love, paid this price for you in full by allowing Jesus Christ, his only Son, to die in your place on the cross. Jesus, the same one who created the world, came to pay the price for your sin so that you could be set free from the penalty of hell and have eternal life with him in heaven. It's like this: you broke God's law and Jesus paid your fine. Jesus rose from the grave after 3 days and went back to heaven to prepare a place for us. He said in John 14 verse 1-3, "Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you may be also." The Bible tells us that if we believe in Jesus, we pass from death to life and escape the wrath of God, which comes upon those who do not believe. To believe believe in Jesus, you must, number one, accept the fact that God is the creator of all things and that He is holy. Number two, accept the fact that you have sinned against God and are deserving of hell. Also, that you are 100% responsible for your own sin before God. Number three, recognize God's gracious gift of love in paying the price for your sin by dying on the cross. Number four, accept that Jesus died for your sin and rose again from the dead. Number five, repent or decide to turn away from your sinful ways. Ask God to forgive you in Jesus' name. Number six, accept Jesus as the Lord of your life. Commit your life to Him to serve and obey Him in everything. You can pray a prayer something like this. Heavenly Father, I come to you today in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. I recognize that I have committed many sins. I have lied and stolen and done so many things that are wrong. I pray, Father, that you would forgive me in Jesus' name, that you'd wash away my sins with the blood of Jesus Christ, and you would forgive me, Lord. Today I choose to repent and recognize you and make you the Lord of my life. I give my life to you today and pray that you would create a clean heart in me and help me to live my life for you in Jesus' name. Amen. Number seven, read your Bible every day. Speak to God in prayer daily. Find a good Bible-believing church. Walk in repentance daily and tell others about Jesus. If by God's grace you have given your life to Jesus today, then visit wayofthemaster.com/10principles, where you can find more useful information about starting your new life as a disciple of Jesus Christ. I hope we will meet one day in heaven.